What it do, YouTube? This is your boy, the console scrub. It's Gyro, playing on the Xbox 360. We're going to be playing some post-patch Strike a Car Can TDM. I'm going to be using the PP2000, and it is effing beastly. Look at that guy. Super high level running around with a jackhammer. Time to get fucking raped, kid. And I don't even switch him over. I'm switching over my friend Deja, so... yeah, but anyways, like I said, the PP2000 is effing beastly. If you guys watched my Dow 12 is effing beastly commentary, then this is just going to be a little bit of the same thing of wherever I tell you guys, go check out this gun. Go check out the PP2000. The thing has so little kickback post-patch. I mean, you guys, look at this. Look at that. Barely any kickback, and I'm just tapping on that trigger, tapping on that trigger. Pre-patch, I thought that the PP2000 for the Xbox 360 was really fucking bouncy. I mean, you would barely tap that trigger and the gun would just start going straight up. Look at that guy. That is a way to chill out on a railing, so. As you guys can see, though, I'm running claymores, of course, because I'm not going to let my back just be out in the open. And you never really get to use C4 or mortar during a TDM match in most like cases that I've experienced, but I will get that double on that high level colonel right there. He's like a 64 or a 54 or some shit, but this guy tries to come back for me so many times. I mean, just over and over and over, you know, but they just can't run. They cannot run from the death that is the PP2000 itself. So, but attachments real quick that I will suggest to you guys would be, of course, the red dot Kobra here. That's what I like to use on the PP2000, is the Kobra red dot, along with laser sight and extended mags. Do you see that? He was actually doing something smart. He was being smart about it. He's like, that guy put claymores on the stairs, so that means I gotta crouch walk or crawl on my tummy all the way up the stairs. He almost had it, but I caught him, and a blueberry caught him. So, you know, it's just like, tough luck for you, buddy. But as you guys can also see with the crosshairs, look at how tiny they are. And then whenever I turn on the laser sight, it's just insanely more. Oh, look at that. He just killed himself with them with my own claymore. That's actually quite funny. He killed me with his shotgun, then shot the claymore and probably committed suicide or some shit because I didn't get a kill for it. But real quick, we're going to get on to the story of the day for you guys. This one is actually quite funny, in my opinion. I would fucking have to slap a bitch, no offense to any of the female viewers that I have out there. But this is some stuff that it doesn't matter if you're a woman or you're a man or what. Like, whoever did it to you, you would want to just, like, beat the living hell out of them. But anyways... it is coming from Poland, I'm assuming, since it's a Polish woman, but a dentist pulls out all of her ex-boyfriend's teeth after a breakup. So, if you're planning a trip to the dentist, it might not be the wisest decision to make your appointment with the person you just broke up with, okay? A Polish woman is facing 3 years in prison after she removed all of her ex-boyfriend's teeth during dental surgery just days after their breakup. I tried to be professional and detach myself from my emotions. Anna Makowiak, 34, told Austrian Times, but when I saw him lying there, I just thought, what a bastard, and decided to take all his teeth out. Marek Olszewski, 45, reportedly showed up at McWyack's dental office complaining of toothache just days after he broke up with her. She then allegedly gave him a heavy dose of anesthetic, excuse me, pretty much heavy dose of horse-like tranquilizers, you know, knock his ass out, lock the door, and then began removing all of his teeth one at a time. I knew something was wrong because when I woke up, I couldn't feel any teeth, and my jaw was strapped up with bandages, Olszewski said. She told me my mouth was numb and I wouldn't be able to feel anything for a while, and that the bandage was there to protect the gums, but that I would need to see a specialist, he said. I didn't have any reason to doubt her. I mean, I thought she was a professional. Adding to his trauma, Olszewski said his new girlfriend has already left him over his now toothless appearance. And he also says that he's going to have to pay a fortune on getting dentures or something like that. But the chick is currently being investigated for medical malpractice also. So, I mean, she's going to be going to jail. I mean, just because she could have just really, I think, in my opinion, told him, hey, I can't do your teeth. You're going to have to go to a different dentist. Because, yeah, I would say from our past as a couple that it just wouldn't be right for me to be working on your teeth. But that bitch is like, okay, I'll do it. And then she locks up the door and takes all of dude's teeth. I mean, he was 45, so, you know, he might have lost a few teeth here and there. But he probably still had a good amount of teeth. Now dude looks like, you know, a 70-year-old fucking cancer patient, probably. So, I don't know. I think that's pretty crazy. Tell me what you guys think. What would you do if a person that you just broke up with took out all of your teeth and they were supposed to be a professional at their job? Would you freak out? Would you sue? Would you just go ballistic and beat a bitch's ass, huh? Tell me below. But commentary is coming to an end, guys. 19-3. Tell those bad kids to get raped. Can't stop my claymores because they're just deadly. If you guys enjoyed them, be sure to comment below and drop me a like. And we'll see you next time, guys. Peace.